Life to Uncorked, the show where we break down your favorite made-for-TV movies one bottle at a time. I'm your host, Patrick Serrano, and today we are talking about My Daughter's Double Life, or Fatal Following. My Daughter's Double Life stars Jacob Young from Young and the Restless, Ren Ashton, Alivea Disney, and Jacey Nichole. Now, on the show, we either pour it up, which means yes, or put a cork in it, which means no, thank you. So, what are we going to do to this movie? Pour it up! Now, if you haven't seen the movie and you want to avoid spoilers, you're going to want to go ahead and press pause and come on back, because I'm going to do a quick little recap starting now.
Heather and her daughter, Allie, are grieving the loss of her husband. Allie keeps a video diary and becomes increasingly frustrated when her mother starts dating a religious man named Jack. Jack wears khakis, sets the curfew, and bans the internet from their home. Mariah helped Allie run away when the controlling becomes too much. They drive to a nearby town in a 60s Volkswagen bus to see a sexy man in an insane-looking outfit named Bridger. Bridger seems a bit too handsy and talks to Allie about letting go of her past and starting a new future. It seems a little culty. He even has her write a goodbye letter to her mother. Allie writes in the largest handwriting I've ever seen, and later she is screamed at for using the phone to try to call her mother. Mariah takes Allie to a field as their final goodbye and throws a necklace into the lake. Very symbolic. Police find the necklace and the goodbye letter and assume that Allie committed suicide. Heather is distraught about her daughter's death, but feels like something is off. She demands to talk to the sheriff of the small town. At a local coffee shop, she runs into Mariah, but Mariah is evasive and mysterious. Heather checks into a local bed and breakfast, and the owner shows Heather some old newspaper clippings that show Mariah died the same way Allie allegedly did. Heather looks for her daughter at the Sunrise Center and sees her daughter in the back of the bus. Knowing that her daughter is alive, Heather heads back to the sheriff, but is gaslit AF. Bridger shows up and says she is harassing him. The sheriff sides with Bridger and threatens to arrest Heather if she doesn't drop it and leave town. Jack shows up with his khaki pants and a gun to keep guard as Heather breaks into the Sunrise Center. She is a mother who is going to save her daughter from the cult. Allie cries to her mother and claims that Jack was planning on marrying her as a child bride. Heather can't believe her ears when Jack confirms that was his plan. Heather realizes that she was in a cult the whole time. Jack killed her husband because he was going to expose the cult. Jack grabs Allie and holds her at gunpoint while screaming at the sheriff. But Heather takes him out with some tool from a shed or something. It's a Lifetime movie after all, and a mother must always save her daughter. The twist is shocking, and it turns out Mariah and Bridger are actually the good guys rescuing people from cults. Heather apologizes to her daughter, and Allie goes on a real date with a boy. And that is My Daughter's Double Life.
So My Daughter's Double Life really was a wild ride. It was absolutely insane. It took the I'm saving my daughter trope, the very Lifetime-y trope of like, I have to save my daughter, someone kidnapped my daughter, and flipped it on its head, right? Fact that Allie is actually the one escaping her mother, who is in, unknowingly in a cult, is crazy. Well, first of all, when you're watching so many Lifetime movies, you like to actually be surprised, and I truly was. This was so did not see this coming, and after I actually watched this twice, and on a rewatch, it does make a lot of sense, and it does come together. So, you know, if you're smarter than me, you probably figured it out, but for me, I was like, what is happening? I like that Mariah and Bridger are actually the good guys. Sure, they have terrible fashion sense, and they seem a little too hands-on for me, but they were actually there to help people get out of cults, and you know, that's what you want in life. You want people to save you from a cult. You don't want people to keep you in one. And if you are in a cult, I'm so sorry. Like, get help. And I'm not the person to help you, but I'm sure someone can somewhere. Talked about Ren Ashton on this podcast before and have said some not so nice things about her. Sorry, Ren. But her acting in this was so great. She really was going through the trauma of losing a daughter. You could totally relate to that. And then all of a sudden, she just is realizing that she was creating all this drama herself. So give her an Emmy or a Lifetime Award or something. Jacob Young, our hunk, was here again. And, you know, he's getting a little older, as we all are. But he's still hunky as ever. So I love him in a Lifetime movie. Bring him back, Lifetime. He's great. And now it is time for the Minority Report, the segment where we talk about representation in TV movies and why it matters. So we did have some good representation here. We had our character of Maya, played by Alivea Disney, doing the most to seem like she was in a cult, but actually wasn't. And we'd love to see that. Love to see someone helping women. We also had Melody Small as a commune girl, and that's it. So, you know, not the most representation, but the representation that was there was good quality. And I think that wraps it up for this episode. If you want more Lifetime Uncorked, you can check out our website, lifetimeuncorked.com, for full reviews. We also are back on the podcast life. We have partnered with Deck the Hallmark, the Hallmark Boys, as I call them. And we're doing weekly recaps of Christmas movies together. Lifetime Christmas movies, that is. They're taking Hallmark and doing that themselves. But if you want to read my thoughts on Hallmark movies, those are can be found on my blog. You can follow me at Patrick Miguel or the show at Lifetime Court. Don't forget to subscribe and like this channel and tell your friends. If you are so inclined, you can donate to our Ko-fi page. And that's it. We'll talk to you soon. Okay, bye.